Erev Shabbat Shalom, dear viewers. This Shabbat, Be'ezrat Hashem, we're going to read Parashat Vayese. Vayese Yaakov mi Be'er Shava, Vayelech Harana. Yaakov Avinu Alav Shalom, he left his parents' house and he went to Haran. The reason with this trip is to find Isha, in Haran. Why? Why in Haran? Why not in Eretz Kanaan? Omeret HaTorah, Rivka and Yitzhak told him, don't take a woman, a girl, from Eretz Kanaan. Go to Haran, Rivka told him, go to my family and find Isha from Haran. When Yaakov got to Haran, he saw a beautiful lady. A girl with Yirat Shamayim, with Midot Tovot, Tzadikah, Hasidah. Her name is Rachel. The famous Rachel Imenu Aleha Shalom. Yaakov loved her very much. And he wanted to marry her. He went to her father, to Lavan, and asked him, Lavan, I want to marry your daughter. Lavan told him, no problem, but not for free. You have to pay something. Yaakov Avinu Hazi didn't have anything. So he told Lavan, I'm going to work for Rachel 7 years. And Yaakov worked for Rachel 7 years. After 7 years, Lavan gave him Leah. He lied to him. In the morning, Vine Leah, he saw Leah, not Rachel. He was upset. He went to Lavan and told him, Lavan, I worked 7 years for Rachel, not for Leah. Why you lied to me? Lavan told him, our custom in Haran is that the oldest get married before the youngest. So what am I going to do now? If you want the other one, no problem. I will give it to you. But you have to work another 7 years. Yaakov Avinu worked another 7 years for Rachel Imenu. For one Isha, he worked 17 years just to get married to this tzaddiket. And Rachel Aleha Shalom, Rachel Imenu, had a very hard time to bring kids to this world. And she went to Yaakov Avinu and told him, my dear husband, Hava Libanim, please pray for me to Hashem. You're close to Hashem. You are Navi. You talk to Hashem. Please pray for me too. I want to have kids. Vim ein meta anochi. It's better for me to be dead. What Yaakov Avinu answered, huh? Atahat Elohim ani? I am instead of God? He was upset that she went to him, that she came to him and asked him for kids. And everybody asked, what? Yaakov Avinu? You worked 14 years for Rachel Imenu. And you want to have kids only from her. And now, when she comes to you and asks you for kids, you're telling her, Atahat Elohim Ani, I am instead of God. I am not God. What she asked from you? She asked for you, please pray for her. The way how your father, Yitzhak, prayed for Rivka. Why Yaakov Avinu answered her? Very weird answer. Omer Aramban, Nahmani, Rabbi Moshe Bar Nahman, a beautiful answer. Yaakov Avinu, he knew that Rachel had a power to pray for herself and Hashem will listen to her and she's going to have kids. But she's not doing it. Why? Because that she married to a Navi, to a prophet. So she relies on Yaakov Avinu and his tefillot, and she's not doing her hishtadlut with the tefillot. Yaakov Avinu, he prayed for her. And he will pray for her. But he wants her to do the hishtadlut of tefillah. He wants her to cry to HaKadosh Baruch Hu to have kids. Don't rely on me. Don't lean on me that I'm going to pray for you. Every person, Rabotai, every person have a koah to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and to get whatever he need. Anything that a person needs, he just need to ask HaKadosh Baruch Hu. I heard from one of the Chachamim in our generation, הרב שלום הרוש. He said that if a person he prayed for something and he's not getting it, it's because of two reasons. Or he didn't pray for it, or if he prayed for it, he didn't pray enough for it. So we really have to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu and do our ishtadut with the tefillot. Sometimes the tefillot is going to be right away. HaKadosh Baruch Hu will listen to you right away. Sometimes HaKadosh Baruch Hu not going to listen to us for 15 or 20 years. We don't know. But we have to do the ishtadlut. Rachel, when she saw that Yaakov Avinu don't care about her and he's not going to pray for her, she prayed for herself. And right away, she got the baby. She did the ishtadlut and HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave her the baby. Give her the first one, Yosef HaSadiq. Rabotai, this is a big musar, a big lesson that we can learn from Yaakov and Rachel from this conversation, from this dialogue. Yaakov Avinu knew that Rachel can get banim with not his help. I don't need to help you. Also, as Rabotai, if we want something, don't go to Babot, don't go to rabbis. It helps, yes. If you need to go, yes, why not? But you need to rely on yourself. You need to pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. If you will pray from your heart, Borei Olam will listen to you. We learn it from Hizkiyah HaMelech. Hizkiyah HaMelech Amar, Afilu Herev Hadam Munachat Al Tzavaro Shel Adam. Even if there's a sword on the neck of the person, Al Ibn Atzma Min HaRachamim, don't stop praying to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. And this is a huge lesson that we learned from Yaakov and Rachel. Yehi Ratzon Be'ezrat Hashem Shehakadosh Baruch Hu Yishlach Banim Zecharim to all the people that need Banim Zecharim and Hatzlacha Beracha to all Am Yisrael. Shabbat Shalom and Besorot Tovot.